Morning students, so today we are going to discuss next portion of our first chapter, some basic concepts of chemistry. So today we are going to discuss two laws. Those two laws you have discussed in your 9th standard also. So first law is law of conservation of mass. Okay, before discussing this, let me tell you, there are five basic laws which are applicable during any chemical combination. So whenever some chemical change occurs, then those five laws, out of those five, there will be applicability of few laws. Okay, so there are five laws which govern any chemical change. So very first law is law of conservation of mass. So this law was proposed by Lavoisier. This picture you can see, this is Lavoisier. Now what this law states? In a chemical reaction, mass can neither be created nor destroyed. That is, total mass of reactants always remains same as the total mass of products. Okay, now see, let us check this with an example. Carbon reacts with oxygen to form carbon dioxide. Okay, so this reaction can be written as C plus O2, it gives CO2. Now, it also means, according to mole concept, which you have done in 9th standard also, here also in 11th you are going to do it. So from this this equation, what we can say, 1 mole of carbon combines with 1 mole of oxygen and there is formation of 1 mole of carbon dioxide. Now, 1 mole of carbon has mass equal to 12 gram, equal to its gram atomic mass. 1 mole of oxygen has mass equal to its gram molecular mass, so it is 32 gram. Similarly, 1 mole of carbon dioxide has mass equal to its gram molecular mass. So this comes out to be total mass of reactants is 44 gram, 12 plus 32. And similarly, CO2, it will also have total molecular mass as 44. So 44 grams in total of reactants combine to form 44 gram of products in total. Now, second law. This law is law of definite proportions. Now, this law was proposed by Proust. This picture is of Proust. So what it says, in place of definite proportion, we can also use the word definite composition. Okay, so we can use any one of the two. Now what he said, in a chemical compound, the elements are always present in the fixed ratio by mass. So this is just like the definition of compound. In a chemical compound, the elements are always present in the fixed ratio by mass. Now, what it means? It means when we are talking about any chemical compound, then whatever may be its source, the ratio of masses of its elements, that will always remain constant. Just like here in this example, they have taken carbon dioxide compound. Now, two situations we have taken. First is, carbon dioxide is formed by the combination of carbon and oxygen. So, in this way, CO2 is formed. Second is, decomposition of calcium carbonate. When calcium carbonate decomposes, it forms calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So, carbon dioxide is formed in both the cases. When we will check this carbon dioxide, whether it is obtained by one method or by other method, when ratio of the masses of carbon and oxygen will be taken, it will be 3:8 only. So it will be fixed ratio. Okay, so students, for today we will be discussing only these two laws. Now, on the basis of these two laws, you have to do this homework. Thank you.